Hello everyone, this is Miroslav from ComAp Technical Support Department. In this video, I'd like to show you how to configure your inputs and outputs. So, inputs and outputs can be configured via GenConfig software tool in this inputs and outputs I/O card. So, if you click on this tab, you can see that here is an option to configure binary inputs, binary outputs, and analog inputs, and also analog outputs. Analog output is available only in IntelliSys controllers, not IntelliGen. In default archives, there are some functions already predefined. So as you can see, for example, on binary input number 1, there is GCB generator circuit breaker feedback. And on each binary input, you can configure a separate logical function. So for example, on this binary input number 1, here is already mentioned GCB feedback, which is controller internal function. And you can also assign a custom protection on each binary input. Custom protection can be created by clicking this checkbox protection and by selecting protection type. It can be warning, alarm, and so on. You can also change name of binary inputs and outputs. But there is just a limited space for the name itself. So if you would like to type something that is longer, you need to just use shortcuts. So for example, if you would like to configure binary input number 11 with new function, for example, remote manual. So after activating of this binary input, you would like to force the controller to manual mode. You need to select binary input, check function, and select remote manual function. You can also again assign a protection to this binary input, but it's not mandatory, so I don't want to have a protection. Binary outputs can be configured in quite similar way as binary inputs. So for example, if I would like to configure binary output number 9, I don't want to see logical 1 in case that the controller is in ready state, but I would like to see logical 1 if the controller is in off mode. I need to select this binary output, then click to source and find appropriate logical state. So in my case, it is off mode. This one. This binary output can be also linked with an output from PLC and so on. So not only logical binary outputs can be used. You can also change the name of your binary output. And you can also invert the logic. So in case that the controller won't be in off mode, I will receive logical 1 and vice versa. The next group are analogs. Analog input can be also configured by using a predefined function. So for example, in case of analog input number 1, there is an oil pressure function configured by default, but you can of course change it to a different one. So again, it is a checkbox for selecting appropriate function from this list. And you can also set up a protection on this particular analog input. You can rename it, you can change dimensions. So for case of oil pressure, it's of course bar, but in case of something else, it can be voltage, hertz, and so on. You can also change the type of sensor, or in case that you cannot find your specific sensor, you can create your own. Creation of custom sensors will be part of another video. You can also set a resolution of your sensor and you can change its range. You can set up a protection on your analog input by clicking this small square. And in this window, you can configure the protection according to your needs. Details can be found by clicking or pressing F1 on your keyboard. You can also change the percentage of bar graph that is shown on one of external screen. And you can change the offset as well. In case that you are creating a configuration for IntelliSys controllers, there is an option to configure also analog output, which can be again configured by clicking this analog output and selecting its source. It can be based on many sources like RPMs, voltage, and so on. You can also convert the analog output signal by using this convert functionality. And you can change the limits. So for example, RPMs are from 0 to 1500. So this is the range of the source value and you can convert it to a current signal, let's say from 0 to 20 milliamps. Output type can be chosen between current, voltage, and PWM with probing physical range. If no conversion is used, you can normalize the analog output by using this normalize feature, and you can select desired resolution. So it means that if you would like to send over your analog output value of RPMs and you would like to normalize it to two decimal places, there will be something like 1500.00. This is the normalization. PWM frequency is available only if the output type is set to PWM. So this is the frequency of output signal. So that's it to configuration of inputs and outputs. Thanks for watching, and in case of any questions, just contact our technical support department at support@comap-control.com.